The insights now are like just wow. And not much to do with them. It's so big. It's such a big turnaround. You're not really sure what to think or do. It's a little frustrating if you're used to really being able to, you know, go, 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 go. When you really turn around, you just say, well, I'm not really sure. What's the next question, really? Do you see this world? For one, you see that the purpose of this world, one of the purposes is to not be helped, to get rid of all help, actually. The idea of this world, as far as help goes, is help us by becoming confused yourself, so you can't help us. It's like, wow. Now, another purpose of this world is an excuse, actually, to not drop the stance of hallucination. An excuse from this cycle. They're like two sprockets, like a, and there's a chain, and this, the chain is moving. And there's, say, higher and lower. We just different positions on the sprocket, and we get to the higher sprocket, and we think, oh, we're really high up now. Well, the world is just an excuse for us to say, we can't drop the stance of hallucination yet. That we got these problems in this world. We got to solve the problems of this world. You know, look at all the poor suffering people there. We can't drop that. But just think that we are projecting this whole world as an excuse, actually. Consider that possibility. So, in considering that, you just say, whoa, I don't know what to think now. It could be a very good justification for relocation to paradise, a death-free realm. It is possible, right? If you recognize this world is actually just a projected, manufactured excuse, just an excuse we're using to avoid dropping the stance of hallucination because we have a phobia about that. If we recognize all this and we say, you know, I know a way to work on this phobia and gradually diminish it, which we've been doing, then you can say, well, I don't need this world at all. I don't need an excuse to fail. I don't need an excuse to delay. So why not go to a world where there's no problems at all? And we can just work on our continuity fear. That would open could open some doors, couldn't it? And so this has all been percolating with me, and I don't know what to make of it exactly. You see, Jesus is like a wild card in all of this, and what the scriptures say is that he left and said he'd come back, and he went left to prepare a place for us, would come back at the end of the age and to bring us there. So this is quite different than a lot of teachings. So this is a big question. It's a big question. Are things just going to continue on as they have for the last thousands and thousands of years here? And we just have to try and, you know, do our progressive meditations, our yana, you know, stage 1, 2, 3, 4, and then after stage 4, the higher yanas, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then finally reach the 9th, and, you know, do all this, you know, Buddhist practice, and our Christian prayer practice, or you know, what is it? You know, is it graduated endeavor right now, or is there some really very much definitive situation going to take place here? This is really the meta question of these times. And I'm struggling to get an answer because I cannot get a handle on the future here as to what to do. It just seems non-existent. And maybe it feels like it's not even necessary to struggle with this world. It may be the struggling of this world is only a scam. Okay, all of this struggle, help, 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 we're trapped. Imagine if when we made our stance of hallucination, we took the stance of being a hallucinator, wanting to be prime responsible for creation, being the prime creator instead of God. And in doing so, we then believe that what we were prior to hallucinating is actually the hallucination. you see. And what we're hallucinating is reality. So then we feel we need what we're hallucinating, or else we'll be annihilated, it'll disappear, it won't be any us, it won't be any identity, it won't be any reality at all. We believe what we're hallucinating is reality. So we say, wow, how do we make sure that we don't let go of this? Well, one way is to imagine that there's this pit and of layers and levels, and down in this pit are all these sentient beings that need salvation. So, oh God, they're suffering, they're dying, they're sick, it's horrible. We gotta save them. Just consider the possibility that we are simply imagining all this actually. Isn't that not possible, actually? The creativity we have is capable of imagining, universes right away. Well, what better way to make sure that we don't stop hallucinating, because we think if we do, reality will vanish, than to say, wow, we really have, there's like a need to, look at all these beings we need to rescue. They're in so much trouble. Wow, what horrible. We've got to help them. We can't just let them go, let them suffer like this. We've got to rescue them. We've got a mission to rescue them. We've got to go down in that pit and get them out of the pit. Now, what I've received from Jesus is the recognition there is no pit. There is no pit. I had that dream where I felt I was in this pit, and I've been working for so long to get out of it. And I was just pulling myself out of it, and there was Jesus on a horse, totally calm on this beautiful flat plain, calm, peaceful plain. And I just reached up my hand and said, hey, pull me out. I feel my strength is, waning. I can hardly, didn't do anything. And I slipped back into the pit, back into the darkness, back into the hell. And I was saying, wow, Jesus, what is the matter with you? Well, then I eventually realized there is no pit. If he's reaching down to pull me out, he's just strengthening delusion, actually. So if there is no pit, well, why are we imagining there is? What motive could we have? Well, once we understand the stance of hallucination that we've taken, the motive is to keep hallucinating, thinking that's reality, and therefore not realize we're hallucinating, and therefore having a very good rationale to not even look at it. We say, how selfish, how could we even look, question this? That's crazy. Look at all those people, these sentient beings, in so much misery and suffering. My God, gotta help them. Help bring them up to where we are, up into the light. Bring them up into the light. So, we have this huge Uber mission that nobody can even question. It's so full of compassion. What if we're hallucinating this whole pit and all these sentient beings in order to play the compassion card, like, God, I can't stop hallucinating. Look at all these beings that need my help. Well, those beings are also being hallucinated. So you see how this is a game changer, and it's not easy to deal with this, because you don't quite know where to go and what to say. It's not been easy for me here, this turnaround. I was just like, wow. You think, what kind of dialogue can I have with anybody about this? Because not everybody's, locked into their, most people, spiritual path, are locked into some practice. I have to get enlightened. Maybe we don't need to get enlightened. See, maybe we're just, this is just a projection. And to give up the projection is the real key, right? All this enlightenment, wow, it's going to take lifetimes and lifetimes, and it's very difficult. And, well, that's a nice delaying game, isn't it? It's a good excuse. Now, Radical Dzogchen cuts through that, and Jesus certainly, in my interaction with Jesus and the teachings and everything, he definitely seems to know this whole issue, right? This whole issue, actually. Don't need the world at all. The world's just an illusion. There's nothing of value here whatsoever. Well, etc. Now, Radical Sakchan just says, hey, there's nothing to enlighten. There's nothing to release. Everything, an unreleased event is impossible. There cannot be an unreleased world. There cannot be unreleased beings. There cannot be unreleased troubles. None of that is possible. This points out then this is a hallucination. We're desiring it to be so. Interpreting, hallucinate, we want it to be this way. As an excuse, has to be as an excuse based on a very severe phobia. So this is rewriting the book, as it were, on what's taking place here. Connecting the dots. We think this human is our identity and we need to enlighten it or something. Really? Maybe this human is just an excuse that our spirit is using to delay based on a phobia that our spirit has. And that this human is just a mere appearance. Like, and everything here is just ephemeral mere appearance. There's nothing, no need for enlightenment anywhere. Nothing can ever leave its true self-sprung nature in the now. There's nothing to release. There's absolutely nothing needs to be brought to release whatsoever. Now, of course, seeing this, there'd be no excuse to keep hallucinating, would there? Our excuses would be gone. So maybe all of the struggle we're having are just an elaborate excuse that we are working on. A ruse, a hoax, a con, an elaborate excuse. And we claim compassion. We can't leave this behind, God. This world needs us. That's like having a dream and say, I can't wake up from this dream. The action in the dream needs me to help out. You know, there's people who are in danger in this dream. I can't wake up from the dream. I mean, I'm sure we've all had dreams where the action's been so adventurous and dangerous, and people, and we wake up barely and we say, wow, I gotta go back sleeping. I gotta go back to this dream because there's people in danger and I need to help, stuff like that. And when you wake up, you finally say, wow, I think I let those people down in the dream. They needed me. So I would say our fundamental problem is a continuity problem, continuity fear of letting go of the stance of hallucination. And we wouldn't have any rescue operation, compassion operation, locational identity, vulnerability. We have just this complete smoothed out perfection, vision of oneness. And we'd think, well, what do we do? How do I function? Well, what's I? How do I get enlightenment? Who needs enlightenment? Is there something that is somehow separate from the totality that needs to be put back in it? Or needs to be filled up with spaciousness? It's not saturated by pure spaciousness? Is there something not properly in pure spaciousness? You know, is there any problem actually with reality? And the answer is no, there isn't any problem. So what do we need to do? This is the question. And we don't need to do anything. We don't need to solve any problems, aren't any. Except this continuity fear, this phobia. We have a phobia of letting go of a hallucination. It's irrational. We have an irrational phobia, actually. Now, this information we may not know what to do with it, but at least we're getting used to it. See, this is the key. Familiarity is the key. At least our comfort zone is being moved. I have a feeling at some point it will come in handy. I have a feeling that it's spirit that gets angry with us when we don't recognize the troubles and say, what are you talking about? You can't leave this world. This world's got problems. And we say, no, it doesn't. Actually, it's just all a projection. It's got the same kind of problems as a dream scenario has problems. No real problems at all. The problem is the phobia of spirit. And the thing is, spirit is so scared, it doesn't want to deal with that phobia. It doesn't want to be helped. So it's insisting that we spend all our focus here trying to solve the problems of this dream world. So we're not focusing on this phobia of letting go of the stance of hallucination. So to go to a paradise realm, spirit would get very angry and say, we're not going to have anything to do with you. You turned your back on this world. You're evil. You're selfish. You're not trying to help, you know, all this stuff. That's spirit talking, actually. Spirit's fear. Spirit's fear. We just have to say, no. Spirit, you do need some help here with this continuity fear. And that's it. You don't need help with this world. See, spirit fears there's some perfect world somewhere where it would have to face the fact that the world isn't the problem. This world isn't a problem, is it? There's no excuses then. Spirit says, I still feel frightened. You know, they can't project it on the world, can they? They will say, wow, it's not the world's problem, it must be my problem. But here we can always blame it on the world. Jesus says, set the world free from your projections upon it. Set the world free from your projections upon it. Oh, this is a projection. Now, most people are not up to speed on this. This is a fact. Because, you know, a lot of spiritual endeavor in the world and recently in the Western world has been on, you know, progressive path. Like Chan Buddhism, Mahayana Buddhism, or Vajrayana Buddhism, which is Tibetan Buddhism. And Chan is more based on Yana or meditation, Dhyana. Progressive stages of meditation and that. And Vajrayana Buddhism is based on more visualization, mantras, and mandalas, and various active sort of meditations like that. And this has been very popular in the West. Like Zen Buddhism has been actually quite popular in the West now. And same with Tibetan Buddhism. And Christianity is sort of stalled out in sort of saying, well, you know, at some point we're going to be saved. And that brought in the rapture theory of we'll be, you know, whisked away somewhere else. But they're not really quite sure why. Well, I say, well, you know, have faith. You know, they have faith that somehow, you know, it's just kind of fuzzy and vague. So there's very little, you know, real talk about this kind of, it's sort of right now, it's like radical Dzogchen meets Jesus Christ, actually. Because it's really in the same ballpark. It's really in the same ballpark. A lot of what those in the know would say is that radical Dzogchen is not Buddhism. It really is not Buddhism. And it seems It's all a dream. And then why are we dreaming? Is what I've been working on. Why are we dreaming? Why are we dreaming? And Jesus has pointed out this is all a hallucination, actually. We tried to be greater than God. We tried to separate from God, create separately, create, be a separate creator. Instead of accepting the direction of creation, we said, no, we want to be the one doing the prime creating. So then we think that appearance is causing the desire for appearance. That it's primary, that appearance is somehow primary, and thinking that is reality. So we might even say we're objectifying ourselves, that we feel as if this world is objectifying us, actually. I know people say that we're objectifying the world. No, I'd say the world is actually, we're believing it's objectifying us. And so it is true that the progressive path can work on getting free of this objectification. But we're able to question, hey, maybe we don't even need this world at all. This has always been my stance, is I feel like I don't need this world. I don't need this world. I do not. Nobody needs this world. No one here, bodies, humans, don't need this world. They're like dream figures, actually. The idea of a human consciousness is really just a projection, imagination of spirit. That spirit is imagining that there's someone that needs to help. All right. But the idea that human consciousness, we need to help humanity. Humanity is a dream. It's a dream. Spirit's dreaming this as an excuse. As an excuse. It's dreaming this world as an excuse. From its very severe phobia of the abyss of unreality, should it stop hallucinating. So, from the teachings of A Course in Miracles, Bible Course in Miracles, Journey Beyond Words, I found that this teachings of Longchenpa, this very radical Dzogchen, it just fits right in like a glove. I just say, yeah, there's nothing to release. Nothing to bring to rest. Okay, so this is, of course, baffling when hearing this. If you're like baffled for a little while, that's okay. That's okay. I'm in the same boat. It's just. You don't know, you know, exactly. We all want some sort of graduated endeavor here. Think spirit wants that for us because spirit can then claim, well, look, I'm helping enlighten these human beings. gradually, while enlighten these human beings. Yeah. Spirit doesn't want to admit there are no such thing as human beings or a world or this any paths at all, actually. Nothing has ever strayed an iota away from the self-sprung spontaneity of the now. So how could there be a path to get somewhere, to go somewhere? So we will do some exercises now to take a look at this. So we will continue to keep working here and just see where this is taking us. Okay, I know it's not easy because it's like sort of like, whoa, we're crossing into terra incognita here, but it's not that bad. It's not that bad. So just one moment here. Okay, so what we're saying is there's no real confusion. It's imaginary confusion. This is all a game that spirit is playing, a game of delay. What we say is God, pure spaciousness, one way of saying it is I am-ness. There's just total I am-ness. And analogy could be used like a mirror. No matter what you put in a mirror, or the screen that you're looking at doesn't affect the mirror. Whatever's being reflected in the mirror doesn't reflect the mirror. You can even hold up a broken mirror in front of a mirror. That doesn't mean that the mirror is broken, the one that's doing the reflecting. So you might say God is this perfect reflector, absolutely perfect reflector. No matter what is put in front of the mirror, it never changes the nature of the mirror in the slightest bit. This can be talked about. You know, people, there's been a lot of different terminologies: luminous mind, awakened mind, undefiled mind, natural state, Buddha nature, absolute reality, heart, essence, pure consciousness, one mind, essential nature, core being, transcendent reality, emptiness, primordial nature. You know, there's endless. You can say whatever you want to about it. We can just say, I am the I amness, the total I amness that is, that just is, the total I amness. Oh, there's only I amness. That's it. There's no confusion. There's only I amness. Now, this I amness, what we need to remind ourselves, like a mirror, that no matter what's put in there, a shattered mirror could be put in front of it. It doesn't mean that that mirror is shattered, does it? Darkness could be put in front of the mirror. It doesn't mean that that mirror is somehow obscured, does it? You're looking at a reflection from the mirror and you say, oh, I see all this darkness. Wow, I can't see the mirror. No, you're looking in the mirror the whole time. If you're seeing a reflection of darkness, it's like in this video, you're seeing, you know, darkness back here. And you're saying, oh, or do you say, oh, I can't see the screen. Where's the screen? It's, you know, it's so dark. No, you're looking right, you're seeing the screen. As you're looking at this darkness, you are seeing the screen. So as we're experiencing anything at all, we're seeing God. We're only seeing God, actually. Just like you're looking at the screen, you're only seeing the screen. We're only seeing the screen. So, it's helpful to remind ourselves to practice this and wear away, you know, this phobia we have of recognizing we're just looking in a mirror. We're afraid that if we recognize we're just looking in a mirror, we'll cease to exist, because we keep thinking that what's being reflected is the reality, and we pretend that we're not aware of the mirror at all. We're not aware of God, pure spaciousness. You see the self-sprung spontaneity of the now. So we use some terms here, and you can just sort of relish these terms and just get the taste, the flavor of them. And I did some of this on the last video, but it's worth going over and adding some to it, actually. So I am cannot be, and this is how we say it. I am cannot be found. I am cannot be found. And imagine that mirror then. Imagine, you know, or the screen. Imagine you're looking everywhere in the screen. Is it here and here and here? And you're waiting and looking. Say, where's the screen? Where's the screen? I'm looking for it. I just can't find it. Is this the screen? Is this the screen? Or is this the screen? Is this by the... Where's that screen? Everything is the screen, right? All of this is totally the screen. So, I am cannot be found. I am cannot be reached. Again, looking at this, and I'm trying to find the screen. Where is the screen? This is all the screen. I am cannot be reached. I am cannot be sought. Meaningfully sought. Okay, I'm seeking. Where's the screen? I am cannot be liberated into. Cannot be liberated into. Can I say, okay, I'm about to be liberated into the screen here. Okay, about to be liberated. Okay. I am cannot be liberated into, cannot be released into, again. I'm saying, oh my, I gotta be, what are you doing? I'm trying to be released into this screen. You know, I'm separate from it now, but I'm working on being released into it. Hello? We're totally there all the time, aren't we? I am cannot be developed. Yeah, I'm working on developing being in the screen here. I am cannot be seen. Cannot be seen. Cannot be seen. Is there some place outside of the screen where we can see the screen? So yeah, I'm outside of it, but now I'm seeing it here. No, everything is on the screen here. I am cannot be grasped. Oh, okay, now I see. I see. I'm gonna grasp it here. Whoops! Everything is already there. It's already there. I am cannot be objectified. Cannot be objectified. Now I'm seeing. Now I'm seeing the screen. Yeah, it's out there. Cannot be objectified. Cannot be timed. Cannot be timed. Okay, what is the time that there is I am? What time is I am? Cannot be timed. It cannot be attained. Cannot be attained. Yeah, meditating. Why are you meditating? I'm working on attaining this screen state. Yeah, I'm not there yet, but I'm working on it. So what do you mean? Everything is already on the screen. You don't have to attain it. I am cannot be embraced. I am cannot be embraced. We cannot say, oh, there's I am. Let me embrace it. You know, it's there. I am cannot be impressed. Impressed. Yeah. You know, I am. You can say, I am. I've been working really hard to find you. You know, aren't you impressed by that? I am cannot be depressed. I am. I just can't find you. You know, it must be so depressing for you. I can't find you. No, I am cannot be realized. Realized. Oh, yeah. Okay. Now I see I am. There it is. I've realized it. I am cannot be arrived at. It's like we're going. Arriving. I'm arriving. I'm arriving. Hey, I just arrived into I amness. Wow, I just arrived there. From where? From where? From where? Stepped into. Again, I'm just ready to step into I amness. I just stepped into it. From where? From where did we step into it? I am cannot be calculated. Cannot be calculated. Okay, how much of I amness is? Well, let me calculate this. I am cannot be purchased. How much is I am? How much does it cost? I mean, cannot be purchased. I am cannot be owned. Owned. I say, well, I think I'm going to own this here. I am cannot be entered into. Cannot be entered into. Say, okay, from where do we enter into it? Okay, I'm ready to enter into the screen now. I am now entering into this screen. I am cannot be entered into. I am cannot be liberated. I am is somewhere it's stuck. I need to liberate it. I need to liberate I am. I am cannot be thought. Cannot be thought. I'm thinking of I am. I'm thinking of the screen. I'm thinking of the screen. Is the one who's thinking of the screen not on the screen? If I start thinking, so I'm thinking about being on a screen. Am I not still on the screen here? The whole time I'm thinking about it. I am cannot be a concept. Cannot be a concept or conceptualized. Again, I have this concept. I have a concept of being on the screen. Well, does that change anything at all? No. I am cannot be shown. Cannot be shown. How can we show? To what? To what? I want to show. Here's the screen. Can you see the screen now? Let me show it to you. Even that is never separate from I am, right? Mm-hmm. I am cannot be added to. Cannot be added to. What can we add to I amness? It was everywhere. What can we add to it? I am cannot be subtracted from. Subtract. Here, let me subtract something off of the screen. There you go. I just subtracted. Let me add something. I just added this to the screen. There you go. Now it's on the screen. I am cannot be divided. All right, I'm going to divide the screen. So just okay, right in the middle, right here. Over here is on the screen. Over here is now it's been divided. I am cannot be assisted. Let me help here. Let me help this along. Let me help this be on this screen here. I am cannot be boosted. Let me give this a boost. It seems like I'm falling off the screen just for the screen. So let me give it a boost here. Let me boost up the screenness of it. No, I am cannot be boosted. I am cannot be inspired. Cannot be inspired. I get an inspiration. You know what? You need to be on the screen. You're really good on the screen. And I hope you get on the screen. I hope you stay on the screen. I hope you don't fade off the screen. I got an inspiration. Cannot be inspired. I am cannot be defended. Cannot be defended. What do I need to do here to defend the screenness here? Do I need to say I am here to protect the screenness of this? And without this protection, there would be no screenness of what you're seeing. I am cannot be intrigued. Cannot be intrigued. Hey, I am. You know, this is, I got a very interesting story for you about how you left the screen and then came back to the screen, and this was a screen before, now it's not a screen, and now it is again, and cannot be intrigued. I am cannot be obscured. Cannot be obscured. But I gotta say, was the screen just obscured? Was the screen obscured? No, cannot be obscured. I am cannot be defiled. I cannot be defiled. Yeah, can we do something here? The screen defiled. No, it's not. I am cannot be championed. Cannot be championed. We cannot say, screen, I am your champion. And I have saved you. I have saved you, screen. And here I am, screen, as your champion. I am cannot be protected. Yeah, protected. Protected. Yeah, it's like I am standing here in absolute protection of the screenness here, and I'm not going to let anything interfere with this screenness here. I am cannot be protected. I am cannot be pleased. I am cannot be pleased. Can I say, hey, screen? Am I pleasing to you, screen? Yeah. Is this pleasing? This is pleasing. Nice pleasingness for the screen. I am cannot be reassured. Let me reassure you, screen, that you really are a screen. You see, I need to be reassured. If I don't reassure you, you might not be a screen. This doesn't need reassurance. I am cannot be progressed. Progressed. We don't say, hey, screen, you're doing really good, but there's a lot more progress that you need to make. I'm going to stay here and help you out with the progress of being a screen. I am cannot be progressed. I am cannot be shown off to. Cannot be shown off to. Hey, screen. You know, look what I'm doing to make you a screen. You see, look at all this great stuff I'm doing to make you a screen. I am cannot be given hope to. Screen. I want to tell you something. That even though it looks bleak, you can really make it. You know, you really can. I'm gonna tell you, you can. Cannot be given hope to. I am cannot be shown adventitiousness. Adventitiousness. Hey, screen. I want to tell you, this is a very, very, very good situation you're in right now. See, very good situation. See, this everything here is just very adventitious for you, screen. No, I am cannot be shown adventitiousness. I am cannot be shown disadvantage. Hey, screen, I'm telling you, this whole setup here is actually not very good for you at all. So I am cannot be shown disadvantage. I am cannot be shown outcome. Screen, I'm telling you that this is how it all ends. Okay, this is what is going to take place here. Okay, let me tell you what's going to take place. I am cannot be shown outcome. Well, that's what I just said. I am cannot be shown fertility. Fertility. Screen, I want to tell you that you can be so much more. You can be so much more. You can be reproduced. Okay. Cannot be shown. You're capable of birth, screen. You're capable of being something even more. I am cannot be shown abundance. Screen, let me tell you how you gotta pay attention to the incredible abundance there is here. Screen, I am cannot be shown brightness. Brightness, brightness, brightness. Wow. Screen, let me show you just how bright you can be. Well, look at that. You know, I am cannot be shown a brightness. It's still the same screen. I am cannot be shown clarity. Hey, look at this clarity screen. Look how you just suddenly cleared up. See, you're fuzzy, and then, boom, you cleared up. Cannot be shown. I am cannot be shown clarity. I am cannot be offered. Let me make you an offer. Let me make you an offer here. It's a very important offer. You need to pay attention. I'm going to make you an offer. What can we offer the screen? I'll offer you this screen. You want me to offer you this? I am cannot be given. Screen, I have something to give you. I really have something I'm going to give you. Here you go. You got it. I am cannot be purposeful. I am cannot be purposeful. Screen, what am I fulfilling your purpose, screen? I hope I'm fulfilling your purpose here by being here, screen. I am cannot be possessed. Cannot be possessed. Hey, I've got the screen. I'm appearing on it. I have it. I've got the screen. I am cannot be abandoned. I am cannot be abandoned. I'm gone. I just abandoned the screen. Oh, the screen is still there. The screen is still there. I am cannot be pleased. Hey, I am. Is this pleasing to you? Is it pleasing to you? Or is this more pleasing to you? Is this more pleasing to you? Screen. You know, I am cannot be pleased. I am cannot be disappointed. Cannot be disappointed. Say, wow, screen. I really have done a terrible job here, haven't I? You must be very disappointed. I am cannot be enhanced. I am cannot be enhanced. So we say, oh, screen is no good. I mean, look, oh, there, you're enhanced, screen. No, I am cannot be enhanced. I am cannot be increased. Let me increase you, screen. Here, let me put a whole bunch of stuff on here, and this is going to increase you. I am cannot be increased. I am cannot be decreased. Wow, screen. I think I'm gonna go over here. I'm gonna decrease you somehow. I'm gonna decrease you. I cannot be decreased. I am cannot be moved. You see, hey, I'm moving. Is the screen moving? Is the screen moving? I am cannot be moved. I am cannot be shifted. Cannot be shifted. Is the shift? Is the screen shift? I am cannot be shifted. I am cannot be altered. I am cannot be altered. Cannot be. Is this altering the here? This up here, over that, over there, okay. Can it be altered in some way? Can it be altered? I am cannot be shocked. Did that shock the screen? Oh, I'm so shocked. Is I am shocked? Is the screen shocked? I am cannot be shocked. I am cannot be reified or concretized. Say, okay. The screen just turned to stone. Just to return the screen to stone or something? No. Cannot be concretized or reified. I am cannot be crystallized. Cannot be crystallized. And we say, hey, here's something, you know, here's glass. Did we just crystallize the screen? We just turn the screen into glass? Did we crystallize it? No. I am cannot be crystallized. I am cannot be turned. There's are we turning the screen? Are we turning the screen? No, the screen is not turning in any way. I am cannot be processed. Processed. Okay, let me go through this and this and this and this. Let me do this. This is processed. I'm gonna take this off. I'm gonna take a drink. Is there any process that the screen is going through? So I am cannot be processed. I am cannot be puzzled. I am gonna be puzzled. It's green. And it's very strange. You're very strange. You know, I don't understand you. I don't get it. I really don't get you, screen. Is the screen puzzled? I am cannot be puzzled. I am cannot be reactive. Reactive. Wow. Hey, screen. Hey. Is the screen reacting? No. I am cannot be reactive. I am cannot be pensive. Can I? I am cannot be pensive. Thinking. Is the screen pensive? Is the screen pensive? Is the screen pensive? No, I am cannot be pensive. I am cannot be sluggish. If I'm like, oh, sluggish, suddenly very sluggish. This is a very sluggish screen. You know, can the screen be sluggish? No, I am cannot be sluggish. I am cannot be clean. I am cannot be clean. It's like something. This is dirty. I need to clean this. Let me clean this up here. I'm cleaning this. Is the screen being cleaned? No. I am cannot be cleaned. I am cannot be scratched. Of course, these analogies fail a little bit pragmatically as you're watching your screen. I am cannot be scratched. If I scratch something. Make a scratch. You're scratching. Is the screen being scratched, actually? No. I am cannot be scratched. I am cannot be remodeled. I am cannot be remodeled. You know, I am cannot be remodeled. Now we got this, like, now let's turn it this way. I'm gonna remodel like this. I like it better this way. Is the screen being remodeled? No. I am cannot be remodeled. Framed. Oh. Here's a nice frame. Is the screen being framed? Is the screen? I am being framed, but is the screen? I am cannot be screened. I am cannot be dressed up. Dressed up. Am I dressing up the frame? The screen? Am I dressing up the screen? No, same screens. I am cannot be dressed up. I am cannot be deepened. I'm deepening. I'm going into the, see, way back in the deepness here. Cannot be deepened. It's the same. I am cannot be restored. Cannot be restored. Yeah, let me restore something. Yeah, do I need to restore this? Let me make this green. Oh, I restored that. I restored the screen. See, I made this plant green again. I restored the screen. Now the screen is the same. I am is the same. It cannot be restored. Cannot be done. Cannot be finished. Hey, I'm done. I'm finished. Screen, okay, that's it. I'm finished. I'm done. Still the screen is there. So this is self-evident, but it's very important to look at it, and we just get a little more comfortable with it. Say, huh, that's interesting. Don't struggle with it. We'll stop in the now. Don't struggle with it. See the change here on the screen and you know, something really happening to the actual screen, or is it just appearances are changing? Just appearances are changing. Just like the weather's changing. See the weather, this is taped outside, the weather's changing. You can hear us, it's a storm coming and rain tonight. But is the screen changing actually? Now what if everything that was happening was just happening on the screen of being? Just a screen of appearances. Would we feel that the screen is in danger from what's happening? Is this what's happening in the world? Is this affecting I amness? Is death affecting IMness? Let's say somebody died on screen. Did the screen just die? Isn't the screen completely alive? Isn't the screen bring everything alive? Even brings death alive, doesn't it? It makes everything possible. There's no death with the screen at all. There's no death with IMness. IAMness is not an appearance, is not an appearance. It is simply the absolute totality at all moments. Just like the screen is always the absolute totality of everything that's appearing on it, and also everything that's not appearing on it. Because we're being shown both what's appearing and not appearing, right? The potentiality, the manifestation, and the potentiality. We say, well, this is a wall. It's also not everything else. It's also not everything else in appearance. So full stop with this, full stop with it. That's the thing about the exercises, is don't try and then intellectually tie them into anything. It's like food. You eat your food and then don't start thinking about what's happening to my food. You know, how's it being distributed? You eat the meal, let the meal digest. Do it that way, you have more energy, more attention to eat some more food, to do more practices. Whereas if you start obsessing about, okay, now, how much, what did that do exactly, how much did it do exactly, you know, this, and just, then you just get all tied up with all this concern. It's like if there's like a lot of rain, so if there were a lot of rain right now, would you be running around saying, well, I don't know what to do with this rain. Wow, I need to measure the rain. No, however much rain is going to be, will be how much rain falls. And whatever rain falls, it will automatically flow to lowest, sink in and flow to the lowest points. It will automatically start filling up the reservoirs. We don't have to micromanage the rain. Unfortunately, it's not going to be a lot of rain, just the tiniest trace here. Of course, we're all freaking out. Oh, here comes the rain, here comes the rain. It's a little bit. All the rain's going south to Arizona. They're getting a lot of rain there. That's good for them, but it doesn't help California at all. That is for sure. The land in the Central Valley of California is, some of it's sinking at the rate of 1 foot a year. 1 foot a year. Think about that. How far is it going to sink in 50 years at this rate if we don't, you know? So they're just, you know, they're putting laws, you know, limiting the amount of groundwater you can pump. Which should be, it would be interesting if we don't get rain this year. To replenish the groundwater, because there won't be any water then really pumped. And that's what agriculture depends on here. It's just, you know, the lifeblood, essential industry. Interesting. I read an article. We're just cooling down here, right? We're just cooling down so we don't struggle with it here. There's articles, there's a winery. They have volunteers, those who want to learn how to make wine, and they volunteer to at a winery to help out and do various things, and it's just sort of like a way to just get, you know, just volunteer and get experience for free. Well, the state has outlawed that, and they says no, you have to, they have to be employees, you have to pay them. Why are they doing this? To get tax money. To get money from them. You see how this is really... Do you feel the insidiousness of what's going on in the world? It's just one of a million different tentacles, actually. You can't have people help you, help out, volunteer, unless you're registered as a nonprofit. But they make that very difficult, and there's all sorts of bureaucracy with a nonprofit. So you know, if someone has a business, you cannot just come in and help them out. Pretty soon it will be, you can't come in and help anybody out. They have to pay you, right? And then you have to pay taxes on what they pay you. Wow. Now this is a big problem for the wine industry, which is a huge industry in California. Because they all, a lot of them use these volunteers. Volunteers come in and they learn the wine business. Hands-on training. And now the winery had to shut down. Got fined so much they had to shut down. Fined for back taxes. Put them out of business. So, wow. I'm telling you, the state tax boards, etc., are absolutely vicious. They are going after every penny you can get, and will sue you, will sue you, will do anything they can. That's how desperate they are for citizens have become targets now. The government is now targeting the citizens. Government is supposed to work for the citizens. The citizens are not supposed to work for the government. But, see, that's disappearing. So, how wonderful is that, actually? So, we had better spend time considering some this huge overview of, like, maybe this world is not what we think it is. Maybe this world is not what we believe it to be. Maybe not at all. Not even close to what we presume it to be. As a matter of fact, you've asked most of quote-unquote human beings, what is this world? They don't have a clue. And that should get you thinking right there. How is it that I can appear here in this world and I have no idea what my purpose is? I don't know. Like, who I am? Who am I? I don't know who I am, what my purpose is, what am I doing here, why is this world here? I don't know anything. Doesn't that make you suspicious that it's a dream? And we're not being told, and we want to hide the fact that it's a dream from ourselves. The dreamer wants to hide the fact that it's a dream. But the figures in the dream, they don't know, they don't have any consciousness of what they're doing or why they're in the dream or anything like that. And we're looking at these dream figures and say, what are they doing here, really? What am I, when I say, what am I doing here? I'm spirit looking at this body saying, what is the purpose of this body, actually? Why is this body even existent? I said, I don't know. That is weird. And they could say, well, we're here to eat and to sleep and survive. And so, why? But why? Why is this here in the first place? And see, spirit starts asking these questions of itself. Really, it's really spirit that's on the quote on the inquiry path of inquiry, not a human being. It's spirit. Spirit's the one who's saying, why am I, who's doing this? And of course people say, well, God's doing it. Oh, which really means, don't story, end of story, you know. But my spirit keeps saying, why is God doing this again? Well, why? No explanations is satisfactory, you know. It's simple. This really, God, this is what God's doing. Why is God doing it? Well, no answer really. No good answers at all. So wait a minute. What if Spirit is doing this? Doesn't that make more sense? Maybe this is a dream that Spirit's having. Why would Spirit be doing this? This is real deep inquiry, actually. I always remember, people always told me, I asked questions of the world, and everybody said, I don't know, this is God's work. And they say, why? God's mysterious, we don't know. You can't figure out why God's doing anything. So don't even ask the question. And I always said, no, this is not God's work at all. Forget it, no way. God is not doing this. So this put me at odds with the world. Because the world either says, basically the world says, we don't know and we don't want to know and there is no way to know. So shut up and just go about your survival here, that's it. Since there are no answers in the world, really, it's hard to find them, at least. And it's when you come across them, you think, wow, it's hardly anybody else is even thinking like this at all. And then you may think, like, well, how could this be? If it was true, wouldn't everybody be agreeing? No, not at all. If this is just a defensive dream, which the purpose is to pretend that it's not a dream, and then the purpose is supposedly having to solve all these dream problems, they'll be claiming real problems, and maybe it's just all a delaying tactic, then certainly there may not be, might be very little awareness whatsoever. Because of the severe phobia that Spirit has, there's very little motivation at all to even look into this. It's just stalling. It says, I just got to make hallucination permanent, is what it's really saying. Though it has very little interest in recognizing what's really going on. So Jesus comes along and says, hey, I have something to tell you. So he tells us, and we say, huh? What? You know, how can I, as a human, understand you? You know, you're God, I'm a human. What are you talking about? And Jesus says, no, I'm your brother in spirit, and you're the human that you're thinking you're human, that's just a dream figure. And this is all a dream. And it's a defensive dream to try to maintain the stance of hallucination because the severe phobia that you have of letting go of that stance, thinking that you will cease to reality will cease to exist if you do that. And we say, well, you can do it, Jesus, but we can't. You can let go of that dream, but we can't. We gotta fix all this stuff in the dream. And Jesus says, no. What I can do, you can will do also. You are the dreamer of the dream, just the same as I am the dreamer of the dream. Spirit is the dreamer of the dream. The dream is not dreaming spirit. Spirit is dreaming the dream. You're not really a human at all. You're spirit. I am not a body, I am free. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me to be. So the difficulty here is to say, well, how do I explain that to everybody? How do I integrate that? Integrate it? Why do we need to integrate it? Isn't that just another delaying tactic? Yeah, but how does that fit in with there are a lot of Buddhism, and how does it, why does truth need to fit in with something? Isn't that just another delaying tactic? It's like saying, well, you got something here on the screen and there's something else on the screen. How do these two things fit together? We're looking at the screen. Why do we need to fit things together, you know, on the screen? We don't need the dream. We don't need this. What more needs to be said? Nothing needs, more needs to be said. We don't need to cross-reference this. We don't need to get humans to agree on anything. We don't have to solve this at the level of humans, of spiritual teaching, of a world, of appearances. I mean, we don't need to see it at that level at all. So if there's any seeing that's being done, it's not been done at the level of the dream, actually. So the question is, well, what about, you know, seeing at the level of dream, how does it look then? There, that's futile. That's like saying, well, how do the dreams figure see it? That's non-self-evident, non-resolution. You know, how do the dream figure see the dream? They don't. They don't know what they're seeing. They're not seeing at all. The continuity fear, the severe phobia, brings up all these questions that are pseudo questions, you know, but they feel so like important. You got to focus on this question. Why is it important to focus on these questions? We already have the answer right here. Why are we focusing on questions? Delay, fear. If you have water, you're thirsty, and you want to drink, you sit there and field questions about, well, is this the same kind of water that they had back, you know, thousands of years ago? Or is the water different? Well, you know, is this water the same kind of water as they have over here? And, you know, huh? And they start asking all these questions about the water. It's water. Just drink it. Now, if you drink this water, will it still have the same effect on you as the water that was drunk in some other place, some other times? It's like, say, well, does truth just have the same effect now as it did previously? Is this screen the same kind of screen that we used to have back then? You know, is the screen of totality, you know, how's that affected by what? So it's this questioning, this, you know, that obviously one has to full stop and not do that. Get totally confusing then. What people are really saying with this question is just saying, I'm confused. But what we just said is not confusing. So you cannot really address that because you're simply saying, yes, you are confused. So what we really have to say is, no, you don't actually don't have that question. You're not confused. You're frightened, but you're not confused. This is why the path has a mood of repentance to say, I have a severe continuity problem. I don't have a confusion problem at all. I have a severe continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. The confusion problem doesn't exist, no. Therefore, it has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. We are not confused, we must insist upon this. We just have a continuity fear. So questions really come from this, hey, I'm really very confused. tomorrow. I'm a little confused, dear. No, they're saying, I'm a lot confused. I'm really confused. No, nobody's confused, actually. The truth is very simple, you see. We just don't want to accept it. Period. We're frightened. So if you say, I'm really frightened of the implications, I'm afraid I won't exist. Okay, that's a legitimate, you know, statement as far as admitting that I have a severe phobia. But there's no question about the situation at all. Just have a severe phobia. Like arachnophobia, there's a spider, and they just say, wow, I'm really scared. Why? Do we need to ask why? No, they're scared of the spider, that's all. Is it a complex situation? Not at all. It's just very simple. There's a spider. I'm scared of spiders. It's that simple. And yet, we may think, thinking like, well, I need to calm down, so I'm going to ask a lot of questions. As if somehow, basically, you know, we're saying, well, is there some way to calm this down? Could this be it? Could this be it? Could this be it? What's better is just full stop in the now of it. Don't repress afflictive emotional karma. There's a spider and there's the fear. Okay, I'm just going to not do anything about it. Just accept and recognize that's what's here. And then say, I don't really have a spider problem. I have a continuity problem. Now people will say, well, maybe there's not a spider there, or maybe I, you know, maybe it's something, is it something else, or do you have any insight into maybe it's something else? No, it's certainly there. The phobia we have is certainly a phobia. You cannot get rid of the phobia, but just by trying to just analyze it and just sort of put different symbols on it. Let's call it something different. Let's not call it the continuity fear. What shall we call it? Is it okay if we call it the something else? The fear is still there. So people are so frightened to even do anything about it at all, that they try to avoid it at all costs. They're very, very clever and tricky about this, but are just determined. It's not really that clever or tricky, it's just more just, you know, severe determination. That fear just insists that it has to see it some other way. Okay. So this info is just like, just a total wow, and I'm just going to have to carry that cross, or, you know, carry the cross and see what else we can do to lighten the load here, to lighten the load. Okay, very great. That's it for this video.